Hey, Dr. Morgan Nolte here, founder of Zivli and the Reshape Your Health podcast. We help you lower insulin resistance for long-term weight loss and better health. In this video, you'll learn three things you can do every day to lower blood sugar after eating, and these often work within minutes. Lowering blood sugar after eating is important. Not only will it give you more energy, you'll also reduce your risk for insulin resistance. One of our members, Betty, lost 20 pounds, got off her statin, and lowered her A1C from the pre-diabetic to normal range with a low insulin and inflammation lifestyle. And you can bet that she used some, if not all, of these strategies you're about to learn. As a little background, high blood sugars after a meal occur for many reasons. The two most common are that you ate too many carbohydrates. These can be starchy or sugary foods. The second is that you overate in general, even if the foods were healthy. Sleep deprivation, inactivity, and stress will also contribute to higher blood sugars. With this in mind, let's get to the tips. The first way to lower blood sugar after a meal is to consider food order. According to this study, you will have a lower blood sugar response if you eat your fiber first, then protein and fat, then starches and sugars. Let's take a look at this meal for example. You'd want to eat your broccoli first, your salmon and celery second, and the carrots and potatoes last. One upcoming guest on our podcast is Justin Richard. He has a great Instagram account to follow for examples of this in action. He tests all sorts of different blood sugar hacks. This particular test I'm showing is a screenshot that I'm using with his permission from one of his reels. He compared the blood sugar response from a Snickers alone to fiber, protein, or fat before the Snickers. You can see here that when he had the Snickers alone, his blood sugar rose by 31. With the broccoli before the Snickers, it was only 20. With the protein before, it was 27, and with the fat, it was 31. The second way to lower blood sugar following a meal is to use apple cider vinegar or ACV before you eat. This is not a fad or a hoax. Research shows having one tablespoon of raw, unfiltered apple cider vinegar before a meal improves the post-meal glucose response. On Justin's Instagram account, he compared the effects of having a Big Mac alone compared with that Big Mac with ACV before, and he tested liquid, tablets, and gummies. With the Big Mac alone, he had a post-meal glucose spike of 31. When he had one tablespoon of ACV in water immediately before the meal, his spike was 24. When he had ACV tablets, the spike was 36. And when he had the ACV gummies, he actually had a higher spike than with the Big Mac alone at 44. That's because many of these gummy supplements have a lot of added sugar. So if you're going to use this tip, use liquid ACV or tablets as a backup, but avoid the gummies. Even if they don't have added sugar, they likely still have unnecessary sweeteners. The last tip is the best, and the one that will have the most impact. This is to go for a walk shortly after you eat. Even a few minutes of movement can make a big difference. The type of activity you do isn't as important as the timing. You'll get the most benefit from doing something immediately after a meal. My dad has type 2 diabetes and tried a continuous glucose monitor. He and my mom went out for Thai food, and he had a bunch of white rice with sauce. That sauce likely had added sugar. You can see here that after this meal, his blood glucose spiked up to almost 250. Because he was wearing his CGM, he knew this, and they went for a walk around the block before heading home. That steep decline down back into his target range was thanks to his walk. What's interesting to see is that this one high-carb meal kept his blood sugars elevated all night long and into the next morning. If you have a high degree of insulin resistance, such as my dad, you cannot tolerate high-carb meals very well. For many people, including my dad, having this concrete and instant data is motivating. That data shows him what his body can and cannot tolerate from a blood sugar standpoint. It also shows him how one meal choice can affect him negatively for hours. For more information about how to reverse insulin resistance, check out our insulin resistance diet starter course below. If you found this episode helpful, please subscribe and turn the notifications on so you don't miss upcoming videos. And watch this video next about 10 foods to lower insulin resistance, and this one with 8 insulin resistance diet tips to lower insulin fast. And check out our programs and services here to lower insulin resistance.